Jefferson Platinum Project out in beautiful Santa Clarita. We're about halfway through this bad boy. Really, really big project. Super excited to be here. And man, what a blessing it's been. You know, this was an unexpected project that we actually picked up. And, you know, it's just been, it's been awesome working for these guys. And, you know, honestly, I think as time goes on, I think we're going to try our hardest to work with good relationships, because at the end of the day, we could work with all types of different GCs and owner builders and stuff like that. But I think when you can partner with the right people and you can work with the right contractors, you'll get taken care of. As long as you take care of them, they'll take care of you. And if you think about it, you know, working in the commercial industry, you know, it doesn't matter, large commercial contract industry like I do, in the construction cleanup business, you know, your partners are everything. It's like doing business with a homeowner. You know, that if that homeowner's awesome, he's gonna take care of you or she's gonna take care of you. It's the same thing when it comes to the relationships you build with your commercial contractors, the people that you're doing business with. I personally do business with big construction companies and people that do developments and stuff like that. And we're their personal cleaners that go in and take care of everything on the project. Everything from the exterior cleaning, like if you see these buildings here, we cleaned all the tile on the exterior, the windows, we cleaned the facades, okay? But then we also take care of the interior. But every single one of these buildings, there's about 500 units here. This is only about, what you're seeing right here on this video, is only about maybe 150. So there's 480 total. So you can imagine there's probably like another 7 of these buildings that you're seeing right here, about 9 of these buildings total all around the property. Anyways, really, I think what I'm making this video about is like making the relationships with the right business partners, not just business partners, but people that are gonna do, that you're doing business with, that write your checks, has a lot to do with the growth of your company. See, when I first got started, and I was first getting in the business, I did business with anyone. And I got screwed over once or twice, you know, trying to get involved in this business where I didn't get paid, things like that. See, some people say the construction cleanup business is no good, blah, blah, blah. You know, my answer to that is you probably don't know how to run your business as a construction company, and you don't have the right relationships with the right people. Because the difference between having a bad relationship with the wrong GC and the right relationship with the wrong GC, just having the right relationship, period, is when you need something, whether it's a change order or you need more money, they're there to help you, right? They're not there to screw you. Because what a lot of these developers and a lot of these general contractors are doing is they're on a budget. They're on a very small margin. And they only have so much money to make on their project. And so obviously they're not gonna be paying out extra tabs for no reason. They're only gonna pay if they know it's the absolute certainty that they have to pay it, okay? And so having a great relationship with them goes a long way, okay? Tactical, let's get into tactical one more time and then we'll get into the mindset stuff. So tactical meaning, how do you build a relationship with these people? Well, first and foremost, it starts from the very beginning, right? It's the impact that you made from the very start of what you said to them when you met them. Did you like when you shook their hand, did you shake their hand with certainty? Did you show them that you are the guy that's going to help them? Second, don't show up to a meeting with a cup of coffee for yourself because you're sipping on coffee and not bring anyone else anything. Anytime I go to a meeting, and a meeting, by the way, is an unannounced meeting, right? Just showing up, okay? That's a meeting too. That's how most of my meetings go, is I just show up on their property. I bring them a box of donuts or a box of bagels, you know, something that shows that, hey, I'm looking out for you. I'm not just looking out for myself, right? So that sets the tone from the very beginning with these superintendents or general contractors or any sort of business relationship that you're trying to start. I don't care what business you're in. So setting the tone, showing them from the very beginning that you're looking out for them by bringing them something, not just yourself. Okay, that's number one is confidence, shaking their hand with certainty that you can do the job. Number two is bringing them something to show them that you're looking out for them, not just yourself, right? So here's the thing, okay? We're talking about how do you build these relationships? Well, by doing that, you're creating a relationship. Number three is taking the time that once you've gotten the business and you're working with them to check in on them, follow up on them, right? What can you do that's different from the rest of the subs and whoever else that is working with this person? What can you do that's different? Well, one of the things that you can do that's different is you can actually send them like a Christmas card or send them just a simple text on Christmas saying, hey, Merry Christmas. On New Year, say, hey, Happy New Year. You know, I hope everything's good. I hope everything's good with the family. And you got to remember, you're not just doing this just to make an impact and just to make an impression. You're doing this because you truly care about that relationship. You truly care about nurturing that relationship. So things like that go a long way, man. They remember you, they stick. It's called being on the top of mind for them, that you're always in the front center of their mind and they know who you are. You're not just another guy out there in the field, okay? These would be my top ways that you build a relationship with these people. Okay, now let's get into the mindset, okay? Top three, we can recap it one more time. Number one, shake their hand with certainty. Show them that you're the guy. Number two, bring them a gift, okay? Bring them bagels, bring them donuts. It could be very small. It's just showing them that you're not just looking out for yourself, you're looking out for them. And it's gonna go a long way because later in the project of whatever you're doing business with them with, if you need more money, if you need help, you need an extra few days to finish your project, they're gonna give you that leniency because they know you're looking out for them, you're not just looking out for yourself. And then number three, nurture the relationship, right? Hit them up on holidays, hit them up on New Year's, hit them up on birthdays. Let them know that you are there and you're not fake, okay? All right, cool. Now let's get into the mindset, okay? Now mindset of this whole thing is you need to be consistent on your habits, man. Your mind is gonna trick you and say, well, why are you gonna do this? Why are you doing this? Like, there's no point in doing this. Like, why are you putting in all this extra effort? None of these other guys are doing. Well, the old saying goes, man, like, you're not gonna do what everybody else is doing because what everybody else is doing is probably the wrong way. If everyone else is doing something, for instance, I tell my guys here at in my business, we have about 25 people now, maybe 30, and we fluctuate. A lot of them don't wanna work Saturdays sometimes. And so I explain to them, I say, hey, look, I say, if everyone doesn't wanna work Saturdays, there's probably good reason for that. And it's probably because it's something that makes you uncomfortable and it's something that is not creating pleasure immediately. And so you wanna go opposite of that and you want to do it because it's going to make you successful. People that don't work Saturdays, obviously it's the larger mass of people, the 95% are willing to take the Saturday off while the 5% are willing to work on Saturdays. Meaning, the 5% are willing to send these text messages out on birthdays, holidays, things like that, and bring donuts and nurture relationships. So you need to do those kind of things. Create these habits, I promise you. If you do this over a small extended period of time, it will become second nature, and that's what you just do in business now. Like, that's your normal get down. It's not like you have to try anymore, right? I'm telling you guys, you can't just expect people to give you contracts, expect people to give you money. Like, you can't just create a cold relationship out of nothing and just say, hey, I'm giving you a good price, give me the business. No, man, you gotta nurture it. You gotta show them. Anyways, that's my message for today. I don't make too many of these videos anymore, but you speaking out and commenting and saying things like, John, this really helped me. You know, John, this is awesome. You know, that really does help me and it motivates me, inspires me to continue to make these videos so I can help you on your entrepreneur journey and get to your first $1 million in your company. That's why I put out these videos, is because I want to be known in the marketplace as somebody that helps other people, you know, build their business and build their brand and do what it is that they're trying to do. Because I remember how hard it was for me to get the momentum and how helpful these videos were. I just had to find the right people to listen to. So if this is helpful, drop some stuff in the comments, like this, share this, let me know that you enjoy it, and I'll keep making videos like this, okay? It's your boy, John. I hope all you overcomers out there are working hard and going into 2021 ready to grind, because I'm ready. Talk to you soon.